Shalom, family of Messiah Yeshua. Shalom to the worldwide YouTube and social media community. This is your beloved brother Shaul Yisrael, coming back again with another Yahweh-inspired message. I'll be reading from the book of 1 Peter chapter 2, starting at verse 1. 1 Peter chapter 2, starting at verse 1. Again, 1 Peter chapter 2, starting at verse 1, and I read, "Wherefore, laying aside all malice and all guile and hypocrisies, and envies, and all evil speakings, as newborn babes, desire sincere milk of the word that you may grow thereby." Then turn to Hebrews chapter 5, and then start in verse 12. Hebrews 5 and verse 12, and I read, "But when for the time you ought to be teachers, you have need that one teach you again, would be the first principles of the oracles of Yahweh. And have become such as have need of milk and not of strong meat. For everyone that uses milk is unskillful in the word of righteousness, for he is a babe. But strong meat belongs to them that are of full age, even those who by reason of use have the exercise discernment of good and evil." Hebrews chapter 6. "Therefore, leaving the principles of the doctrine of HaMashiach, let us go on unto perfection, not laying in the foundation of repentance from dead works and faith toward Yahweh, of the doctrine of baptism, and of laying on hands, and of resurrection of the dead, and of eternal judgment. And this will we do, if y'all permit." I read it to say this. The introduction to discipleship begins first with the new birth. Because in order to become a disciple of Yeshua, our soon coming king, and to become a disciple of Abba Yahweh, you must be born again according to the set apart scriptures. And to be born again, you must repent of your sins, and you must be baptized in water in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach for both the pardon of sins and the regeneration of your soul. And you must receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit as initially evident by speaking in another tongue, and Yahweh permits one to speak. Once you are born again, then you must patiently and gradually develop into the renewed man. And the process of development of the renewed man takes place by first reading the scripture. Once you are born again, it's not wise to go out there witnessing to people. But wisdom instructs one to first read the scripture, starting at Genesis chapter 1. Reading the scripture, become acquainted with the words of the living El Yahweh. Next step in the process of development into the renewed man is to diligently listen to sound preaching and teaching of the set apart messengers of Yahweh. That you may develop into the renewed man. Third step is prayer without ceasing. Invoking Abba Yahweh to strengthen one, to give one patience, and to stir up the gift of the set apart spirit within you, that you may patiently endure the various trials, temptations, and persecutions that are come to prove oneself and to purify oneself, that one may be further developed into the renewed man. This is the process of discipleship, because the will of Abba Yahweh is for disciples to be made and to be developed into the image of his beloved son, the renewed man. For among the disciples who have reached maturity in the renewed man, Yahweh will raise up men, mature men, to be apostles. He'll raise up mature men to be prophets. He'll move those apostles to appoint qualified men to be bishops or deacons. But the introduction to the ministry starts first with discipleship, or the making order of disciples. So, my beloved brethren, don't be quick to witness to nobody until first you have become thoroughly acquainted with the scriptures. And to be thoroughly acquainted with scriptures, simply read the scripture. As it's written in 1 Timothy chapter 4 and verse 12, let no man despise your youth, but be you an example of the believers in word, in conversation, in charity, in spirit, in faith, in purity. Till I come, give attendance to reading, to exhortation, to doctrine. So you're to give attendance to reading of the scripture. Be mindful of what the scripture says, to study, to show yourself approved unto Yahweh. They need not be a workman that need not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word true. By the scripture. The scripture is not limited to 60 books. The scripture, there's no number attached to the books of scripture. There's more than 60 books inspired of Yahweh. So when you give attention to reading the scripture, read every word of Yahweh. Be patient in the reading of scripture. You can type on YouTube or Google about the audio Bible that you may facilitate memorization of the scripture. Because before witnessing, you must first become acquainted and intimate with the word of Yahweh. This is vital in one's development as a disciple of Yeshua HaMashiach by becoming intimate with the word of Yahweh. That comes by reading the scripture, studying the scripture, being prayerful unto Yahweh concerning understanding of the scripture. For in order for a disciple to reach maturity in the renewed man, he must be developed. And this development takes place by the preaching and teaching of the word of Yahweh, by the reading and study of the scripture, and by praying without ceasing. Because prayer is our lifeline to our Yahweh. Through prayer, we maintain and we cultivate our relationship with our Yahweh. So let us not neglect prayer, supplication, and intercession before Yahweh. So this is vital to our development in the renewed man. So, a mature disciple is one who has been rooted and grounded in the milk of the word. And the milk of the word are the foundational doctrines of the word of Yahweh. What are the foundational doctrines of the word of Yahweh that undergirds and that is the basis of our faith in Abba Yahweh? The belief in one God, strict monotheism. The new birth, the means of reconciliation with Yahweh. And three, set apart living. Under set apart living, you got the observance of the feast days. The observance of the dietary instructions, the observance of the scripture dress code, The observance of the code of conduct, how we properly interact with one another as assembly, even as family, and how we interact with those who are not of the family of Yahweh, those who are of the world, those who are sinners. These are the foundational doctrines of the word of Yahweh. All true disciples of Yeshua HaMashiach, all true disciples of Abba Yahweh, will be rooted and grounded in the milk of the word. So I pray Yahweh that he continues to weed out from among the Israelite community the undesirables, the deplorables, the hypocrite, the untrue, the fake, from the real, from the wheat, from those who are sincere and sound in heart, and continue to further prune them, that they may produce, that we may produce more and more fruit. Abba Yahweh, continue to send forth your fiery, steadfast, and certain rebuke upon our enemies. Continue to grievously plague them, O Yahweh. Even upon my enemies here in Persia County in Rockford, North Carolina. Continue to send forth your consuming wrath upon our enemies, O Yahweh. Continue to grant us strength, O Yahweh. Continue to increase our faith, O Yahweh. Continue to refine and prune and develop our faith in you. Continue to purge out of us, O Yahweh, any and all vestiges of the religions of this world. For religion is not of you, O Yahweh. And continue to let us manifest more and more of your set up our spirit. Renew your spirit within us, O Yahweh. Continue to direct and guide us. Continue to cover and immerse and adorn us with your uncommon favor, your healing mercies, your loving kindness, your wisdom, your great power. For our Yahweh, we need you more and more in these last new days. We need your wisdom. We need your power. We need your shalom, O Yahweh, that we may stand firm in the midst of hard times, that we may thrive in these hard times and overcome in these hard times. Continue to prepare us for the coming persecution that has been decreed to come to this earth. Strengthen us, O Yahweh. I ask you to strengthen us. Renew your spirit within us. Continue to strengthen us, O Yahweh. I thank you for hearing my prayers, O Yahweh. Thank you for increasing my faith, O Yahweh. And for electing your servant according to your favor and according to your mercy. And charge me to preach and teach your word. I give your name glory, honor, and praise, O Yahweh. There's none like you. I thank you for your beloved son, Yeshua HaMashiach, for granting him the strength and the power and the wisdom to be a living sacrifice, that through his sacrifice, O Yahweh, that I may be reconciled unto you, that I may be empowered to live a perfectly righteous life, not just me only, but for all whom you have called, whom you have chosen, and whom you have reconciled unto yourself, and whom you will reconcile to yourself. I thank you, O Yahweh, in the name of your beloved Son, Yeshua HaMashiach. So be it, so be it. Shalom.